Good evening and welcome to St. Anne's Mass. Today's Mass intentions are the following: for Amparito Navarro, birthday; Cecilia Marina Ramos, 15th birthday; for Mr. Peter Park, a swift recovery; and for the health of Savar Mannequin; and for the soul of Father Antolin Alvarez. Thank you.
Reading from the
open to every good enterprise. They are to slander no one, to be peaceful, considerate, exercising all graciousness towards everyone. For we ourselves were once foolish, disobedient, deluded, slaves to various desires and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful of ourselves and hating one another. But when the kindness and generous love of God our Savior appeared, not because of any righteous deeds we had done, but because of his mercy, he saved us through the bath of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom he richly poured out on us through Jesus Christ our Savior, so that we might be justified by his grace and become heirs in hope of eternal life. The word of the Lord. Responsorial song. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side. With your rod and your staff, they give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Today's saint, Martin of Tours, was born of pagan parents. But by God's grace, fortunately, right from early childhood, Martin was interested in spiritual matters. At the age of 10, he just walked into a Christian church and enrolled him as a catechumen and began receiving instruction for baptism. So that was an urge within himself to become a Christian, to embrace the faith. He wanted to embrace Christianity. And of course, in a story, in a nutshell, his life was from a military person to a disciple of Jesus. He gave up his military life and was baptized. But his parents remained the same. They were parents then. He took interest in his mother and persuaded his mother to embrace Christianity and got it done. But his father remained the same. He provided an example of ideal good pastor, educating the clergy and preaching the gospel to the poor. And my friends, while Martin was a very active pastor, he was a great shepherd, he was also a man of prayer, an ascetic, and he was a great apostle, witnessing the risen Lord Jesus in word and deed. He worked numerous miracles, but always out of charity, not for popularity. And as we rightly said, he was a soldier by necessity, a bishop by duty, and a monk by choice. He wanted to be a monk. And he was simple and humble and exemplary in his charity to the poor. He went out of his way to express his God's love in action, implemented in love of neighbor. And St. Martin was one of the founders of the church in France. He was a monk and bishop, missionary and miracle worker at the same time. And one thing in his life, he fought firmly and bravely against heresy and every form of superstition. And he bore witness to Christ by living an ascetical and monastic life amidst his people. And in fact, it was a new form of martyrdom without bloodshed that he embraced. And as we heard in the opening prayer, neither death, neither life nor death could damage his love for Christ. And my sisters and brothers, as we commemorate the memorial of St. Martin of Tours today, may his life and death inspire each of us to follow his example. And following his footsteps, may we offer ourselves wholeheartedly to the triune God. And let us desire and pray that we who admire and honor Martin may also give everything to God. The memorial of St. Martin of Tours invites you and me to trust in God at all times and to abandon ourselves as a prayer for surrender into the hands of God and to let nothing separate us from the love of God. Praise be the holy name of Jesus. Amen. Please stand for the prayers of faith. My sisters and brothers, recognizing the goodness of God who gives us all good things, we now confidently bring our prayers to Him.
For Pope Francis and all leaders church. May Christ draw them ever closer to himself. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For political leaders, may God guide them in protecting the dignity of all, especially the unborn. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the sick and all who bear the burden of sickness, may they share in and know the love of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those gathered here, may God grant us the grace to see his goodness in others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Amparito Navarro, as she celebrates her birthday today. For Cecilia Mariana Ramos, who celebrates her 15th birthday. And for Peter Park, for a swift recovery. And the health of Sabiriar Maneko. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, especially for Father Antolin Alvarez, may they have the joy of eternal life with the saints and angels in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God of light and love, we bring you these prayers today, knowing that you are generous. Hear and answer our prayers according to your most holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
By his works of preaching,
and keep her safe in answer to these prayers. And to the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as not yet we are clean. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." receive His command and conquered your teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from our distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of the Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, peace I give you. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but in the faith of the Church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Thank you.
Maybe now the act of spiritual communion for those unable to receive Holy Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were only there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Grant to us for being restored by the sacrament of unity, O Lord, perfect harmony with your will in all things, that just as Saint Martin of Tours submitted himself entirely to you, so we too may glory in being truly yours. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Go in peace. Glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. And have a blessed evening, everybody.